Breaking, Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell calls it a mistake for Tucker Carlson and Fox News to release the never-before-seen J6 footage. Let me play for you this short clip.
It was a mistake, in my view, for Fox News to depict this in a way that's completely at variance with what our chief law enforcement official here at the Capitol thinks.
Well, that's Mitch McConnell back in the blue right there, babe. That's what it's called, back in the blue. And then Elon Musk responded, I keep forgetting which party he belongs to. And Charlie Kirk, he nails it. He says, Uniparty. Yeah, that's basically it. So as many of you know, we got this footage released. I think it's very important. It shows that the Q Shaman, actually, let me see if I can just pull up the video footage. I know we showed it last night, but for those that missed it, I want you all to see this. So you can show your friends and your family, the people who don't believe you, the Q Shaman being escorted by police through the building, who make no attempt whatsoever to stop him. And not only did they make no attempt to stop him, they actually try to open doors for him. How are you going to charge someone with unlawful entry or trespassing or parading or whatever when you're escorting him through the building and opening doors? Well, look at this. Here he is walking through a mob of police officers who don't care at all. Literally don't care. Here we go. Right this way, sir. Here you are. And then sure enough, when he goes in, he says, thank you to the Heavenly Father for taking the inspiration needed to these police officers to allow us into the building. There you go. There it is.
Down. Chansley understood that Capitol Police were his allies. Video shows him giving thanks for them in a prayer on the floor of the Senate. Watch.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for giving the inspiration needed to these police officers to allow us into the building.
To allow us into the building. Yo, they let these people in the building. And Mitch McConnell, he's mad. It was a mistake the American people get to see this footage of the Capitol Police helping these people. He says it's completely at variance with what the police had said. Maybe the police were lying, because if you really want to believe the insurrection narrative, they were in on it. That's what AOC thinks.
Whoa.
AOC. Inside job. I tweeted J6 was an inside job and the left got real mad at me. But pick one.
Did you get kicked off Twitter?
No.
Ooh.
But maybe... Yeah, look, I'll say this to liberals, the Democrats. You got to pick one. Either the police let these people in and there was no insurrection, or the Capitol Police were a part of the insurrection and were in on it the whole time.
Can I just tell you one thing that people might get ticked off at? I'm glad that the videotape footage is getting out there, but I don't think it's the consequential piece of evidence that we need to see right now from the FBI to DOJ to answer the question you posed.
You mean the consequential, or you don't think it's consequential at all?
To answer the consequential question
of whether
or not that you just posed. I think, as a former federal prosecutor and a public defender who defended a lot of these types of cases, what you need to show is whether or not the FBI and government agents were using undercover operatives and informants on the day of January 6th. Because if you can show that, you know they've been at... Hang on. But the paperwork shows, having run informants, that's a six-month buildup. Minimum.
Right.
Minimum. It's not like they just dropped them into the Proud Boys and said, hey, go, don't disrupt, please. So once you prove that, then you defeat the insurrection narrative with the FBI's own documentation. Forget what the videotape shows.
Just for people who you can't see what's going on in the room, the reason why Cash just said hang on or whatever is because I started smirking and rolling my eyes. And what I meant to convey with that is, come on, we know they were involved.
Well, look, I totally agree, though.
Yeah. I'm not saying I know definitively. What I'm saying is, a reasonable suspicion is that there were agents. There's a video showing a guy with an earpiece pulling people into the building. All right. Mm-hmm. You combine that with the evidence of Ray Epps, and it looks like you have a preponderance of evidence suggesting there may have been federal law enforcement involved in making that thing happen.
I'll get you beyond a reasonable doubt. Two pieces of information. Ray Epps was on FBI's most wanted list one day, and the next day he was off of the FBI's most wanted list. There are only two ways that happens. You die or your informant. Put that aside. Under congressional testimony, Jill Sanborn, who I used to work with, the head of the FBI Counterintelligence Division, in charge of all these investigations, testified under oath when Senator Cruz asked her flat out, were there federal agents involved with January 6th? And she said, quote, Senator, I can't answer that at this time. Not if the answer was definitively no, having been a DOJ FBI guy myself, she would have gone there and said, nope, absolutely not. The reason she said I can't answer that is because of the same stonewalling they gave us during Russiagate with Christopher Steele, Halper, and everybody else. It's the same narrative, and I'm telling you they were there.
So you're saying that she said I can't answer that because the answer is yes, yeah. And that would compromise whatever their operation was.
Exactly.
What's the argument they make that she just didn't know when she didn't want to say yes or no definitively?
There is no way the head of the FBI Counterintelligence Division, the number three ranking person at the FBI, who is in charge of the January 6th investigations, did not know the answer to that. It is not possible.
Sounds like the answer is yes. Matt Gaetz came out over a year ago saying that there was, I think that there was evidence of federal involvement, I believe.
Yeah, here's the other thing. Just follow the money. Everybody wants to know about all the spycraft and all the cool stuff. You know what the FBI has to do to these informants? Pay them. You know what that requires? A bank. Go find out. It's what we did with Steele, right? And I got tortured for it. I went to Paul Ryan and said, give me this one subpoena. And if I'm wrong, you can fire me. And he basically tried to fire me anyway.
Wow.
But then I went and got the FBI records and the bank that paid him. And then the floodgates opened. Game over. They said, there's no way we used informants to investigate the FISA and Donald Trump and all this crap. Well, if they did it then, are you telling me they really didn't do it now?
And yeah.
It's taxpayer dollars.
Maybe they pay with crypto.
Ooh. Maybe.
That's true. And also, I want to say, especially right now, if you Google search this story, the media response is hilarious.
What's it saying? I didn't.
Oh, just every single story is like they're lying about what Tucker Carlson said. Right. One of the first things Tucker Carlson says in this report is we've all seen the violence, and he shows video of the violence. And
oh, I see.
They've shown us this over and over again. What they're not telling you is that there was another portion with a permanent peaceful rally that were let in by police, and that's not a part of their narrative. What they're doing now is they're claiming that Tucker only said right. It was peaceful because they project, they claim that the right does what they in fact are doing all the time. It's remarkable that if you're paying attention to news, if you are a discerning individual, like most people watching this show, you can see it happening. Like Ukraine Gate, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
Joe Biden is on camera engaging admitting to a quid pro quo, unless you do what I demand, mm-hmm. I will withhold federally guaranteed loans to your country, which he has no authority to do. And then when Donald Trump tries to investigate it, they accuse him of doing literally the same thing they were caught doing. Yeah. So in this instance, Tucker Carlson comes out and says, let me be nuanced. Yeah, there was violence. Those people are committing vandalism. They're attacking cops. They'll be prosecuted. These people were peaceful and the Democrats lied about it.
Mm-hmm.
So what do the Democrats and the media corporate press do? They lie and claim Tucker's only telling you it was peaceful.
And here's how you solve that.
Yeah, well, how do you solve it?
Put it all out for everybody.
Yeah, the problem is, I wonder if it's a question of the, I don't know, the intellectual capabilities of the people between, you know, political parties or whatever.
Well,
I wonder if the divide in politics are perspicacious individuals and cogs, zombies, NPCs.
You mean in putting this out? I mean, the decision to put this out rests with the House.
I mean, in terms of the left and the right.
Oh,
is the left predominantly followers and the right is predominantly discerning individuals?
I don't know the answer to that. I think you just got to play the videotape and put it all out there and let the online sleuths do what they do, which is.
But I just get it. But you take a look at what the response from the corporate press is. It's lying.
No, I'm not disagreeing with you, but that's not new.
Well, sure. What I mean to say is, are there people who just lack the capabilities to watch the video you put out? Or will their demoralized brains not allow them to process that information as per Yuri Bezmenov?
I think it's a combination of the two. I think after 6 or 7 years of this, some people just don't have the capacity to process that something like that could happen. I think a lot of other people will quietly in their little group say, okay, we know that happened, but when we go to the microphones, we have to say X.
Yeah.
How much of this 44,000 hours do you think is deep faked?
I think, look, here's how the security footage works, right? In the Capitol, having worked there, a lot of it is just going to be dead time, like empty rooms showing office furniture. Probably half of it, to be honest with you. So now we're down to like 21,000 hours of footage. Still a ton of footage, right? But that's, I think, 17,000 hours of footage, 1,700 days of footage. So just to put in perspective on how much it takes to digest all that.
And I guess AI, they're able to use AI to split out all the footage of non-motion.
Yeah.
So they can just discard that. I'm concerned that it's going to deepfake the Q shaman, not him, obviously, he's a little too public, but deepfake people blowing things up or destroying things when they weren't. I mean, obviously, that's a malicious as hell, but I can, hey, don't count it out. You know, we live in the United States. They're capable of anything.
The one thing the left and some of the media, and I hate to say they had a piece of it right, but the one thing they are saying, which I have to agree with, is that there are portions of some of the people that were saying were totally innocent, where there's actually videotape of them doing something illegal, like trespassing per the criminal statutes or interfering with police officers. So that's going to be the problem, that if you do person by person, like you do the whatever this guy's name is, I don't think Tucker should have started with that guy. He should have picked some guy that was straight up innocent, looked at all the videotape on that one guy, found out he was charged with something he should never have been charged with, and then started with him. This guy is just too divisive of a character to do that with, because I'm sure the left's going to come back and say, hey, check out this video. And I don't know if this is true, but check out this video of him, you know, kicking a cop in the shin or something.
Right? I don't think there's anything of that. I think the only footage they ever showed is him just walking through and yelling at a bullhorn. But it's the iconography.
Okay.
The weird hat thing that he's wearing, the face paint. That's why they targeted him.
I think you're onto something with that. I think the iconography of that day, they really, really wanted the memes to be that the, at least for the left, they wanted the memes to be that it was a violent, you know, serious thing. Anytime I talk about it, it's not odd that I get, you know, pictures of that miniature noose that they put up, the miniature gallows, it wasn't even full size, but people on the left still think that gallows was real and that was a real threat and stuff. So I think I think the meme thing is totally right.
Yeah, I just looked Jacob Chansley up, just searched for him on Brave, and three of the top 10 photos are him screaming. Like that's the image I think a lot of people are looking for, is him going, ah!
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, nah, you know, if you scream, you're... So I think if they... trespassing, like non-violent offenses, they've served time. That's time served. Get them out. Immediately get them out.
If they showed a picture of like some 50-year-old dude with a big beer belly holding a little American flag and wiggling it.
Like holding his baby in his arms or something.
Well, I don't know if he had babies with him, but there's like some big fat guy just like waving an American flag. It doesn't have that same kind of vibe of some dude with a crazy head being like, ah.
Did anybody take kids in that day?
I don't know the answer to that.
Kids, I don't think so. Probably though. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. A lot of these people were at a peaceful rally on the other side of the building that had a permit to be there. And the police open the doors and let him in. And Alex Jones is yelling, stop, don't do it, don't go in the building.
If they're obsessed with blaming innocent people for crime, they're going to lose. It's going to lose. It's not sustainable.
Why do you say that?
I'm not so convinced.
Because it's all the data's coming out. It's becoming apparent. Like people are making fun of them on the news.
But the people on the left are doubling down and saying that Tucker's lying, that it's wrong, blah, blah, blah. And the average normie that doesn't watch a lot of this stuff, that has maybe, you know, an hour a week that they can commit to actually paying attention to what's going on in politics, they're still going to get their news from MSNBC or CNN or whatever. And so I don't know that it's guaranteed that just because this stuff comes out, your average person that is, you know, a normie is going to be significantly swayed. Now, I hope that I'm wrong, but I don't see any real reason to believe that this information is really new. You know, I mean, it's like these are things that people thought and assumed before. I don't think that just because there's confirmation on video, I don't think that your average soccer mom in Southern Connecticut is like, oh, man, Trump should have won.
I'm talking about I will support their investigation if they let the innocent people go. If there are people breaking windows and kicking cops, I want them to serve justice for that. Sure. So if they want, I'll join them in their crusade if they let the innocent people go.
This is why I was saying just a moment ago that I wonder if what really does separate the political factions in this country is cognitive faculties.
Oh, I mean, McConnell was talking so slow in that video earlier.
It's not just
that's
that.
Like it's normalized.
It's you have people who believe literally anything the media says, and no matter how many times they're proven to be liars and wrong, they just keep doubling down. And I'm like, that's a certain level of zombism.
Yeah.
That, you know, a lack of higher brain function. You know, like if someone comes to you and says, do you want a stick of gum? And then you're like, why, yes, I certainly would. And when you pull it out, it snaps your finger with those little prank traps they have. And you go, well, that kind of hurt. That was a dick move. Then you go, here, take another piece of gum. And then you go, I don't mind if I do. Snap, ow, man, stop doing that. Well, do you want gum for real time? Yes, I certainly do. Like at a certain point, it's like, what's wrong with you?
No,
he's just going to snap your finger again.
You're not wrong. There's still people who think that we went into Iraq because there were WMDs there. That's literally never going to change for a certain faction of the populace, even though years later it was proven definitively that wasn't even the case. It wasn't even remotely the case.
There are people that still believe Donald Trump defended white nationalists and neo-Nazis.
I think it was a Mark Twain
quote.
He's
also a Russian asset. Don't forget that.
There was a guy who went on MSNBC and argued that Donald Trump was a Soviet asset. Like, the Soviet Union doesn't even exist anymore.
That was my favorite. Was it
Jonathan Chait?
I enjoyed that.
To be fair, what he said was that Trump may have been an asset of the Russians since the 80s, which would imply he was an asset of the Soviet Union.
In the 80s.
And after the Soviet Union collapsed, the infrastructure of Russia maintained him as an asset for their country.
That's my favorite fan fiction. That is my favorite
comic book story.
Can we do, we need a skit where Donald Trump is like talking and then someone accidentally says the activation code and then Trump starts speaking Russian.
Yeah, like someone that can do. Oh, no. Can you imagine Donald Trump doing the someone that can do a really good Donald Trump imitation but speaking purely in Russian? I don't know how that would be funny, Trump in Russian. Yeah, in
doing
Russian
the,
but doing the
accordion thing
with it.
Mark Twain has this quote. It says it's easier to fool people than to convince them they've been fooled.
Yeah,
and he was a smart dude.
There's a risk that like all this information doesn't convince people. It just makes them say, "Well, I want to pay less attention."
Yep.
You know,
it's if you make them feel stupid, they'll withdraw. So you got to do it in a way that people kind of empowers people rather than be like, "You were so wrong." Look,
totally.
No, be like, "Look how much better off we are now that the truth is apparent."
Thanks for watching this clip from the Timcast IRL podcast. Hang out with us live Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. and become a member over at timcast.com for uncensored, members-only shows exclusive. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you all next time.